This looks like the next Alien prequel. What does director Ridley Scott have up his sleeve? There's definitely something encased in these cells. Is it a perfect killing machine with acid saliva just off the top of my head? All right, hold your blowtorch steady now. Steady, steady. All right, look out, look out. It's coming. It's coming. Look out. Oh, it's only a bee. Actually, it's a queen bee. And queen bees aren't the only ones with strange beginnings. These are hardworking leafcutter bees. They're known as industrious pollinators who make nests that resemble cigars. So, what are some more strange and exciting bee facts? By now, it's common knowledge that bees are crucial for our planet because of their role in pollination and, of course, in making tasty honey. There are over 20,000 kinds of bees. Bees pollinate many of the plants we eat. Without bees, there would be terrible food shortages, environmental chaos, and no honey to put in our tea. But there's even more to this flying insect. Leafcutter bees are important to farmers who grow alfalfa. The bees pollinate the alfalfa, which is a major source of high-quality protein for cows, goats, and sheep. They mostly stay out of people's way, and even if a person really deserves a nice big sting, a leafcutter bee's sting only hurts half as much as a honeybee sting. Leafcutter bees are so named because they cut circular pieces of leaves 12 millimeters in diameter and make cigar-like nests out of them. Sure, these bees are gentle, but it's probably a terrible idea to try to light these up and smoke them. I'm talking to you, teens. The nest contains cells, and in every cell is a ball of pollen and an egg. Every cell produces a single bee. Leafcutter bees make their nests inside wood, in plant stems, and in soil, as well as in man-made structures like buildings. Now, honeybees have a different kind of nest. Wild honeybees make hives in hollow trees or holes in rocks. The worker bees are able to convert the sugar from the honey into wax, which oozes out of their tiny pores and leaves flakes of wax on their abdomen. The workers chew this wax until it softens, then bond the wax into the cells of the honeycomb. The worker bees choose a large female to be the queen bee. Her purpose is to make a lot of baby bees. Queen bees are fed a special secretion by worker bees called royal jelly. Once she lays her eggs about 16 days later, new queen bees are born. Baby worker bees take about 21 days to gestate and then emerge. Drones, who mate with queen bees, are born last after 24 days in their cells. Want to know something wild? Because a hive usually has just one queen, when several virgin queens are born to one hive, they'll fight to the death for the position of queen bee. When a queen bee is born, they make a high-pitched buzzing noise called piping. This is to challenge the other queen bees to raise their little bee fists. The piping queens find each other because the piping reveals their locations. Makes sense. Many may enter, but only one will leave. The winning queen is not satisfied with this carnage. After her win, she scurries around the hive, chewing the sides of any remaining cells with queens growing inside, then stinging and killing the pupae. Hey, nobody said that the queen bee is nice. So stay away from the queen bee. Her loyal drones and worker bees are very protective, and they will fight for their queen. A swarm of bees can inflict a lot of bee stings, causing pain and even death to humans who are allergic to their venom. Killing competition and being alfalfa heroes, that's what bees do. These small creatures are the heroes of our food chain and fierce fighters with villainous stings. Be careful. You didn't think we were going to do a pun, but we did. And that's what makes them crazy creatures.